Ladies and gentlemen, whether we recognize it or not, each and every one of us are in the midst of a war, a great controversy, a cosmic conflict, a supernatural battle between good and evil.
God is sending a worldwide message of warning, but also a worldwide message of invitation. We're going to examine and expose the identity of spiritual Babylon in the book of Revelation. He has some of his people in this apostate church system, but he's calling them to come out. It could be very possible that some of us tonight are still in Babylon. God's faithful people are going to come out because their loyalty is not to a man, not to a church, not to a building. Their loyalty is to Jesus Christ alone. Are you happy in Jesus? Are you on? Okay.
Yeah, I just don't find my glasses, but I'll try to read. Okay.
I hope you enjoyed the whale song video.
Jeg håper at dere likte valsangvideoen.
There's only one place in the world that you can swim with humpback whales legally.
Det er bare ett sted I verden hvor du lovlig kan svømme med sånne valer.
It's the tiny island of Tonga in the South Pacific.
Og det en liten øy som heter Tonga I South Pacific.
It was one of the most incredible experiences of my life.
Det var en av de mest fantastiske erfaringene jeg har hatt I livet mitt.
It was so awesome, we're gonna go back next year.
Det var så fantastisk at vi reiser tilbake neste år.
So you folks are welcome to join us.
Så dere velkommen til å være sammen med oss.
How many of you would be interested in swimming with the humpback whale?
Hvor mange har lyst til å svømme sammen med valene?
But you folks here in Norway have something that's very special.
Men her I Norge så har dere noe som veldig spesielt.
I heard that here you can swim with the orcas, the killer whales.
Men jeg har hørt at her kan dere svømme med sånne drepervaler.
Anybody ever swam with the killer whales before?
Det noen som har prøvd det før?
No one.
Ingen.
You live right here.
Dere bor jo akkurat her.
I hope and pray next time if we ever get the chance to come back to be able to swim with the killer whales and do a devotional clip on them.
Jeg håper at hvis jeg noen gang kommer tilbake at jeg får anledning til å gjøre det.
I believe that the Lord made nature for us to enjoy.
Jeg tror at Gud har lagd disse eventyrene for oss for at vi skal nyte dem.
Through creation we are to become acquainted with the wonderful creator.
Gjennom skapningen så blir vi kjent med den fantastiske skaperen.
Because creation reveals the wisdom and the power and the beauty of the Almighty God.
For skapningen åpenbarer skönheten och kraften I den evige Gud.
There's so many wonderful lessons we can learn from the things around us.
Och det är så många fina läxor som vi kan lära av tingen runt oss.
I'm going to be making another Reflections of Hope devotional clip based upon this region.
Och jag kommer till att lägga en sån här film från den här delen av världen.
It's entitled The Land of the Midnight Sun.
Och den kommer till att heta Midnattssolens land.
And then there's another one I've entitled The Heart of Champions.
Och så är det en annan som kommer till att heta Hjärte av heltene.
Because I learned that in this recent Winter Olympics.
För det att jag har hört att I det sista OL.
That this beautiful country Norway had the most medals.
Så var det så att det landet här hade mest medaljer.
That must make you feel proud, huh?
Gör det att det blir stolta?
Small country with less athletes that were represented in the Olympics.
Ett väldigt litet land med väldigt få atleter som var representerat I OL.
But you folks won the most medals.
Men så fick de mest medaljer.
And I learned when I read the article.
Och jag lärde när jag läste artikeln.
That the way in which the leaders choose their athletes here in Norway.
Att den måten som ledarna valt ut atleterna här I Norge.
Is not just based upon their physical achievements.
Är inte bara baserat på vad de presterar rent fysiskt.
But it's also based upon the character that they have.
Men det är också baserat på den karaktären som de har.
It's much more than the ability of the hands, but it's also the motive of the heart.
Inte bara vad de klarar att göra med händerna, men det motivet de har I hjärtat.
The character.
karakteren.
That also makes us the true champions of the Lord.
Og det er også det som gjør oss til Herrens sanne helter.
And so we want to encourage you to go to our YouTube channel and subscribe.
Og derfor så har vi lyst til å anbefale dere å gå på YouTube
Just
og
search Revelation of Hope Ministries.
Og skrive dere opp på Revelation of Hope Ministries.
Or you can just put my name.
Ellers kan dere bare putte navnet mitt inn der på
and
Google.
And there's some amazing resources there that you can be inspired by and share with your loved ones.
Og dere vil finne noen flotte ressurser som dere kan dele med de dere glad I.
We also brought some of our DVDs and we do have some that are for free on that table, so we encourage you to go ahead and pick up something for free.
Og vi har også tatt med oss noen gratis DVD-er som vi anbefaler dere å bare ta.
Tonight I want to share with you something that's a little bit more inspirational.
I kveld så ønsker jeg å dele noe med dere som virkelig inspirerende.
It's entitled From the Weed of Death to the Word of Life.
Det heter fra dødens ugress til livets ord.
I want to share with you my personal testimony.
Jeg har lyst til å dele med dere mitt personlige vitnesbyrd.
Is that okay?
Er det I orden?
We really need the Holy Spirit to take full control of this service tonight.
Og vi trenger virkelig at den hellige ånd tar full kontroll over det vi skal gjøre I kveld.
Because at the end of this presentation,
For ved slutten av denne presentasjonen,
there will be an opportunity for people to make a solid decision for the Lord.
Så vil det komme en anledning for alle her til å ta en fast beslutning for Herren.
A commitment to the blessed Christ.
Og virkelig stille seg på siden til korset.
For a brand new beginning in Jesus.
For å få en helt ny begynnelse I Kristus.
And I know that there are individuals in this room.
Og jeg vet at det folk her I rommet.
The Spirit of God has been working on your heart.
Hvor Guds ånd har blitt virket på hjertene deres.
And tonight he's calling you to make a decision for him.
Og I kveld så kaller han på deg til å gjøre en bestemmelse
for ham. So I want you to be thinking about that decision as we listen to the message in preparation for the end.
Så jeg vil at dere skal forberede den beslutningen I det dere lytter til budskapet.
Jesus is coming soon, friends.
Jesus kommer snart, venner.
Now's the time to set our house in order.
Nå tiden til å sette vårt hus I ordning.
And so as we begin tonight, I invite you to bow your heads with me as we pray.
Og derfor I det vi ber I kveld, så ber jeg om at dere også må bøye hodene med meg.
Our wonderful Father in heaven, thank you so much for your love.
Underbare far I himmelen, tusen takk for din kjærlighet.
Thank you that you're not only a powerful God.
Tusen takk for at du ikke bare en mektig Gud.
You are a kind and gracious Lord.
Du en snill og barmhjertig Gud.
You love us with an everlasting love.
Og du elsker oss med en evig kjærlighet.
Despite who we are and what we've done and the pain we've caused your heart.
Samme hvem vi og hva vi har gjort og med den smerten som vi har latt ramme ditt hjerte.
And Lord, it was your love that drew us to this place tonight.
Og Herre, det var din kjærlighet som brakte oss til dette stedet I kveld.
Lord, as we've come into your presence,
og Herre, det vi kommet inn I ditt nærvær,
pray that your presence will come into us.
Så ber vi at ditt nærvær må komme inn I oss.
That you reveal yourself to us in an intimate way.
Og at du må åpenbare deg selv for oss på en intim måte.
That you'll convict our hearts.
At du må overbevise våre hjerter
of our desperate need of Jesus.
På hvor utrolig mye vi trenger Jesus.
That we would be led to a deeper commitment tonight.
Slik at vi kan komme til en sterkere overbevisning
that we would have the courage to take our stand on the side of righteousness.
Og at vi vil ha mot til å stå opp for rettferdighetens side.
Please, Lord, remove every demonic distraction lingering in this room.
Vær så snill og ta vekk all demonisk virkning I dette rommet.
And have your own way in our hearts tonight.
Og ha din vilje I våre hjerter I kveld.
In the name of Jesus we pray.
I Jesu navn ber vi.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I invite you to take your Bible and turn with me to the book of Revelation, chapter 12.
Jeg vil gjerne at dere slår opp til Åpenbaringsboken, kapittel 12.
Where we read, in prophetic language, a great controversy between good and evil.
I'm very sorry, but in the midst of everything, glemte jeg brillene mine. Har du lyst til å gå inn på rom og se etter brillene mine? Jeg skal prøve.
Revelation, chapter 12.
Åpenbaringen 12.
Notice what the Bible says here in verse 11.
La oss se hva Bibelen sier her I vers 11.
The context is talking about the war that began in heaven and is continuing to be fought here on earth.
Og her snakker det om den krigen som ble kjempet I himmelen og som fortsetter her på jorden.
It is a great controversy between good and evil.
Det en stor kamp mellom godt og ondt.
Where God and Satan are warring against each other for our souls.
Hvor Gud og Satan kjemper mot hverandre for våre sjeler.
But the Bible tells us here that God's people are going to win the victory.
Men her står det at Guds folk vil vinne seier.
And notice how they overcome.
Og legg merke til hvordan de vil vinne seier. I Åpenbaringen 12:11 så står det
that they overcame him by the blood of the lamb.
Og de seiret over ham I kraft av lammets blod.
And by the word of their testimony.
Og I kraft av sitt vitnesbyrd.
And that they loved not their lives unto death.
Og de hadde heller ikke sitt liv kjært like inntil døden.
Here the Bible tells us that God's people will win the victory over Satan.
Her forteller Guds ord oss at Guds folk vil vinne seier over Satan.
First and foremost by the precious blood of the Lamb Jesus.
Først av alt ved Jesu dyrebare blod.
There is power in that blood, friend.
Det er kraft I dette blodet, venner.
Not only to pardon our past.
Ikke bare kraft til å tilgi oss det som har vært
før. But to give us victory in the present.
Men til å gi oss seier her og nå.
And the promise and assurance for the future.
Og løfte og forsikring om framtiden.
I am so grateful for the blood of Jesus. How about you?
Jeg så takknemlig for Jesu blod. Hva med dere?
Bible says we can become more than conquerors through that blood.
Bibelen sier at vi kan mer enn seire ved dette blodet.
But it also says that God's people will win victory by the word of their testimony.
Men det står også at de hadde seier ved sitt vitnesbyrds ord.
You see, there's something about sharing our testimony.
Det noe kraft der I å dele vårt vitnesbyrd.
That inspires us to victory.
Noe som inspirerer oss til seier.
Because expression deepens impression.
Fordi at når vi uttaler noe, så fordyper det inntrykket som
when
blir gjort på oss.
When we express what God has done for us.
Når vi uttrykker hva Gud har gjort for oss.
It not only impresses the minds of those who are listening to us.
Så gjør det ikke bare inntrykk på de som hører på oss.
But it impresses our own hearts.
Men det inntrykk på våre egne hjerter.
If God was faithful in my past.
Hvis Gud var trofast I fortiden.
Surely he would do the same in the present and the future.
Så vil han helt sikkert gjøre det samme nå og I framtiden.
That's why through the dark experiences in life.
Og det derfor når vi går gjennom de mørke fasene I livet.
We need to be reminded of how the Lord led us in the past.
Så trenger vi å huske på hvordan Herren har ledet oss I fortiden.
We have nothing to fear for the future.
For vi har ingenting å frykte for framtiden.
Except as we forget how the Lord led us in the past.
Med mindre vi glemmer hvordan Gud har ledet oss I fortiden.
And so there's power in the word of our testimony.
Og derfor det kraft I vårt vitnesbyrd.
But whose testimony is it really?
Men hvem sitt vitnesbyrd det egentlig?
In verse 17.
I vers 17.
It tells us that the dragon was wroth with the woman.
Så står det at dragen ble vred på kvinnen.
And went to make war with the remnant of her seed.
Og han dro ut for å føre krig mot levningene
hennes
ett. Which
keep the commandments of God.
De som holder Guds bud.
And they have the testimony of who?
Og har Jesu sitt vitnesbyrd?
The testimony of Jesus Christ.
Jesu vitnesbyrd.
So their testimony really is not theirs.
Så deres vitnesbyrd egentlig ikke deres.
It is the testimony of Jesus.
Det Jesu vitnesbyrd.
Because our personal experience.
For den personlige erfaringen som vi har.
It's really the work of God in our lives.
I virkeligheten Guds verk I våre liv.
I like to say that our history is his story of power and grace.
Jeg pleier å si at vårt vitnesbyrd et vitnesbyrd om hans nåde og styrke.
And because of that we can't take any credit.
Og på grunn av det så kan ikke vi si at vi har fortjent noe.
God gets all the honor and the glory and the praise. Amen.
For det Gud som skal ha all ære og pris og takk, ikke sant?
And so I want to share with you my testimony, which is the testimony of Jesus.
Og så ønsker jeg å dele med dere mitt vitnesbyrd som Jesu vitnesbyrd.
What the loving Lord has done in my life.
Det som den kjærlige Herre har gjort I mitt liv.
And I hope and pray that you will be inspired to know.
Og jeg håper og ber om at dere må være inspirert når dere vet.
We cannot change our past.
At selv om vi ikke kan forandre det som har skjedd I fortiden.
We can give it to Jesus.
Så kan vi gi det til Jesus.
And notice what the Lord promises to do.
Og legg merke til hva Jesus lover å gjøre.
In Joel chapter 2 and verse 25.
Det står I Joel 2:25.
The Bible tells us.
Der står det.
That God will restore to us the years that the locusts have eaten.
At Gud vil gjenopprette for oss de årene som gresshoppene har fortært.
In an agricultural society.
Og hvis man ser på et jordbrukssamfunn.
One of the most devastating things that can happen to a farmer.
Så noe av det verste som kan skje for en bonde.
Is to be invaded by a swarm of locusts.
Det å få en hel sverm av gresshopper innover
åkrene. For years of hard work and labor and investment.
Hvis man har arbeidet og investert I disse åkrene I årevis.
Could be consumed in moments by a swarm of locusts.
Så kunne alt dette bli ødelagt bare ved noen øyeblikk med alle disse gresshoppene.
And that is a picture of the lives that we have lived without God.
Och det är ett bilde på de livene som vi har levt utan Gud.
Because you see friends, a life lived for self.
För det skönne vänner att ett liv som blir levt för själva
is a wasted life.
Det är ett tappat liv.
Consumed by the locust of sin and selfishness.
Ett liv som är spist upp av gräshoppen i form av själviskhet.
And we have all lived that kind of life.
Och vi har alla levt ett slikt liv.
No matter how good we are, we've all made mistakes.
Samma hur goda vi är så har vi alla gjort fel.
We've spoken words we shouldn't have spoken.
Vi har talat ord som vi inte borde talat.
We've broken promises that we wish we would have kept.
Och vi har brutit löften som vi önskat att vi hade hållit.
Lots of time and energy has been wasted in foolish things.
Mycket tid och energi har gått tappt i dumma ting.
And we can't change it. What's done is done.
Och vi kan inte ändra det. Det som är gjort, det är gjort.
But if we give our past to Jesus.
Men hvis vi gir fortiden vår til Jesus.
The glorious promise of the Lord is that he will restore all the time that we had wasted.
Så har vi dette herlige løftet hvor det står at han vil gjenopprette all den tiden som vi har tapt.
All the negative influence we have exerted will be restored.
All den negative innflytelsen som vi har spredt, den vil bli gjenopprettet.
And he will give us a brand new life.
Og så vil han gi oss et helt nytt liv.
And so what has happened in the past, it doesn't really matter, friends.
Så det som har skjedd i fortiden, det betyr egentlig ikke noe
God
for
oss.
God
wants us to move forward, amen?
Gud ønsker at vi skal gå framover, ikke sant?
And so I want to share with you how I've experienced the reality of this promise.
Så jeg har lyst til å fortelle dere hvordan jeg har opplevd dette løftet.
My life is a life that has been consumed and wasted by the locust of sin.
Mitt liv er et liv som har virkelig blitt ødelagt av disse syndens gresshopper.
And I want to tell you today how God has been restoring my life.
Og jeg har lyst til å fortelle dere i kveld hvordan Gud har gjenopprettet livet mitt.
But first let's go to the book of Ezekiel chapter 37.
Men først skal vi gå til Ezekiel 37.
In Ezekiel the 37th chapter,
i Ezekiel kapittel 37,
we find a remarkable story of revival and reformation.
Så finner vi en bemärkelsesvärd historia om väckelse och reformation.
And I've taken this chapter as my own story.
Och jag har tagit det här kapitlet som min egen historia.
I see myself in this chapter.
Och jag kan se mig själv i det här kapitlet.
And I want you to notice what it says. Ezekiel chapter 37 beginning with verse 1.
Och jag vill att ni ska lägga märke till vad som står här i Ezekiel 37 vers 1.
It says that the hand of the Lord was upon me and he carried me out in the spirit of the Lord.
Herrens ånd kom över mig och den förte mig ut vid Herrens ånd.
And he set me down in the midst of the valley which was full of bones.
Och satte mig ned mitt i dalen.
And he caused me to pass by them round about, and behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry.
Den var full av bein, så lot han meg gå rundt hele veien forbi dem, og se, det var svært mange som lå der i den åpne dalen, og se, de var meget tørre.
Here the Lord takes the prophet Ezekiel not to the mountaintop, but to the valley.
Här är att Gud tar profeten Ezekiel inte upp på en fjälltopp men ner i dalen.
And as he looks around he sees nothing but dry dead bones.
Och det han ser omkring sig så ser han inte något annat än torra ben.
There was death and decay on every side.
Det var död överallt.
Such a discouraging sight.
Så kedlig att se på.
And the Bible tells us that these bones were very dry.
Och Bibeln berättar oss att dessa ben var väldigt torra.
Ezekiel surrounded by death and decay.
Ezekiel med döden runt omkring sig.
And friends, that's kind of like my life.
Och vänner, sån var livet mitt.
When I was born into this world.
När jag blev född in i denna världen.
It was like I was born in the midst of a valley of dry bones.
Så var det som om jag var född in i en dal av döda ben.
Here's my story.
Här är min historia.
From the moment of conception, he was not wanted.
Fra det øyeblikket jeg ble født, så var jeg uønsket.
Because he was conceived out of wedlock by two young people seeking pleasure outside of the joy that only God can give.
Fordi jeg kom til ved to unge mennesker som ikke engang var gift og som bare hadde det litt fint og søkte lysten, og så kom jeg til.
And this young, pregnant, soon to be mother.
Og denne unge kvinnen som skulle bli min mor.
Was embarrassed and ashamed of the unborn child in her womb.
Hun var så flau over dette barnet i magen.
Because she was so young and she was not married and yet she got pregnant.
For hun var så ung og hun var ikke gift og likevel var hun gravid.
Her parents told her that she was an embarrassment to the family.
Og hennes foreldre fortalte henne at hun gjorde skam på familien.
And so this mother feeling all alone and not wanting to face the responsibility of parenthood.
Så denne moren hun følte seg helt alene og hun hadde ikke lyst til å møte utfordringene til å være en mor.
Was tempted to have an abortion.
Och så var hon fristet till att ta bort.
Even tempted to commit suicide.
Hon var till och med fristet till att ta självmord.
And the young soon to be father too wasn't interested in keeping this child.
Och han unge som var far, han var heller inte intresserad I att ta vara på barnet.
But God prevailed against the suggestions of the devil.
Men Gud, han var starkare än det djävulen föreslog.
And as a result, my mother decided to keep me.
Och min mor bestämde sig för att hon ville behålla mig.
And so I was born on June 19, 1983.
Så jag blev född I juni.
Ain't I a cute kid?
1993 tror jag det var.
And even 83. Though I was born and raised in Hawaii.
Och selv om jag blev född och uppvuxen I Hawaii.
Born in paradise, it wasn't always a beautiful sight.
But, jag var född I paradis och var det inte så paradisiskt.
Because like Ezekiel, when I came into this world, it was like a valley of dry bones.
För akkurat som Ezekiel så kände jag att jag kom in I en dal av döda ben.
My friends, what do these dry bones represent?
Vänner, vad representerar dessa döda benen?
It represents brokenness of spirit.
Det representerar en brutt ånd.
Notice what the Bible says in Proverbs 17 and verse 22.
Och Bibeln säger I Ordspråkene 17:22.
It says a merry heart does good like a medicine.
Ett glad hjärta ger god legedom.
But a broken spirit dries the bones.
Men en sönderknust ånd törker ut benene.
So dry bones are a symbol of brokenness of spirit.
Så tørre ben, det et symbol på at vi har en sønderbrutt ånd.
That really is the description of the family that I was born into.
Og det var den slags familie som jeg ble født inn I.
I grew up in a broken home.
Et brutt hjem.
My parents were not spiritual or religious people.
Familien min var ikke åndelige eller kristne.
Here's a picture of my mom and here's a picture of my dad.
Her har dere moren min og faren min.
And most of my life they were separated.
Og det meste av livet mitt så var de adskilt.
Now I knew that my parents loved me.
Og jeg visste at foreldrene mine elsket meg.
But it seemed like they hated each other.
Men det virket som de hatet hverandre.
There was a lot of anger and bitterness and animosity between my mom and dad.
Det var så mye sinne og onde følelser mellom moren og faren min.
And I grew up in the midst of this dysfunction.
Och jag växte upp mitt I denna här familjen som inte
fungerade. I would live with my dad and other times I would live with my mom.
Någon gång så bodde jag med pappa, någon gång så bodde jag med mamma.
And they didn't know God.
Och de kände inte Gud.
So they couldn't give to me that which they didn't have themselves.
De kunde ju inte ge till mig det som de inte hade själv.
Prayer was never offered in my home.
Det blev aldrig bett hemma hos oss.
The Bible was never read.
Och Bibeln blev aldrig läst.
The songs of Jesus were never sung.
Och de sångerna om Jesus, de sjöng man aldrig.
Growing up I had no idea what was God or who was God.
Och när jag växte upp så hade jag ingen idé om vem är Gud, vem är han egentligen?
Totally ignorant of spiritual things.
Jag var helt ovetande om andliga ting.
It was a broken home.
Det var ett brutt hem.
And maybe you can relate with that this evening.
Och kanske kan du relatera till det ikväll.
Perhaps you grew up in a broken home.
Kanske har du också växt upp I ett brutet hem.
Maybe there's dysfunction in your family tonight.
Kanske är det något I familjen där som inte fungerar.
Friends, I want you to tell you that our God can restore the years that the locusts have eaten.
Jag bara vill fortälla dig att Gud kan återupprätta de åren som gräshopparna har förtärt.
Here's the solution to the brokenness of spirit.
Här är lösningen på en sönderbrutt ånd.
Proverbs 16:24 says.
Ordspråkene 16:24 säger.
That pleasant words are as a honeycomb.
Att goda ord är som honningkaka.
Sweet to the soul and health to the bones.
Söt för själen och hälsa för benen.
It is the pleasant word of God that brings life to the dry bones, friends.
Det är Guds styrbara ord som ger liv till de döda benen, vänner.
But growing up I never knew the power of this word.
Men I det jag växte upp så kände jag inte till kraften I detta ordet.
I never tasted of its sweetness.
Jag hade aldrig smakt denna södmen.
And without a strong spiritual foundation.
Och utan att ha en stark andlig grundlag.
From a very young age I started getting into a lot of trouble.
Så började jag komma in I mycket problem som helt ung.
When I was in elementary school in fifth grade.
När jag gick I femte klasse.
I became a compulsive liar and a compulsive thief.
Så började jag att verkligen lyva och stjäla regelmässigt.
I would burglarize people's homes and steal marijuana plants from neighbors' yards.
Jag ville bryta in I folks hus och stjäla ting och stjäla marijuana planter från hagarna till folk.
This was me when I was in fifth grade.
Det här är mig när jag var I femte klasse.
Don't I look innocent?
Ser jag oskyldig ut?
But the hat says it all, right?
men hatten säger allt där står det icke
oskyldig. It was when I was in fifth grade that I started smoking for the first time.
Och I femte klasse började jag att röka för första gång.
I was a troubled kid.
Jag var verkligen ett
problembarn.
Having
no direction in life.
Jag hade icke någon riktning I livet.
All kinds of problems in my home.
Alla möjliga problem I hemmet mitt.
Heading down a road of crime and corruption.
Veien gikk nedover, og jeg ble kriminell og begynte å gjøre dumme ting.
And when I got into high school, things only got worse.
Og når jeg kom videre I skolen på videregående, da ble det bare
verre. I went to high school simply to get high. That's why they call it high school.
Det var litt vanskelig å oversette, men jeg gikk på høyskole bare for å bli høy. På narkotika, kanskje,
I became addicted to a lot of different things.
Og jeg ble avhengig av mange forskjellige
addicted
ting.
To drugs,
avhengig av narkotika.
Addicted to girls
avhengig
and
jenter,
partying.
Avhengig av fest.
And I was looking for happiness in all the things that the world could offer.
Og jeg prøvde å se etter lykke I alt det som verden kunne tilby.
Searching for something to quench the dry, thirsty bones of my life.
Så etter noe som kunne tilfredsstille disse tørre benene I livet mitt.
During that time I was living with my mom.
Og I løpet av den tiden så bodde jeg med moren min.
As a single parent she tried her best to steer me the right way.
Og hun gjorde det beste hun kunne som en enslig mor for å lede meg I riktig retning.
But she was lost herself.
Men hun var jo en fortapt sjel selv.
But she tried her best.
Men hun prøvde sitt aller beste.
But I abused her love.
Men jeg misbrukte hennes kjærlighet.
Took her for granted.
Jeg tok den for gitt.
She would work late into the night as a nurse.
Hun ville arbeide på sene nattevakter som en sykepleier.
And while she's at working, I would sneak out of the house and have a and run around the town doing crazy things.
Og når hun ikke var hjemme, så snek jeg meg ut av huset og gjorde helt gale ting.
Come home in the morning and sleep half the day.
Og så kom hun hjem, sov halve dagen.
And while she's sleeping in one room.
Og mens hun sov I ett rom.
I would invite all my friends into the next room, my bedroom.
Så inviterte jeg alle vennene mine inn på soverommet mitt.
We would lock the door.
Og så låste jeg døren.
Put a towel on the bottom of the door.
Og så tok jeg et håndkle sånn at liksom hele sprekken var dekket nederst ved døren.
And we would light up the incense.
Og så tente vi røkelse.
And would have a smoking session right next door to the room that my mom was sleeping in.
Og så tente vi alle de her narkotiske stoffene som vi røyka like ved siden av moren min sitt soverom.
When my mom looked at me, she also saw a dry bone.
Og når mammaen min så på meg, så hun et dødt bein.
I was lost and I didn't know how to be found.
Jeg var virkelig fortapt, og jeg visste ikke hvordan jeg kunne bli funnet.
In the midst of this seemingly hopeless situation,
og midt I denne situasjonen som så håpløs ut,
I want you to notice what God asked Ezekiel.
Så har jeg lyst til at vi skal se på hva Gud spurte Ezekiel om.
In verse 3.
La oss se på vers 3.
God says, son of man, can these bones live?
Gud sa, menneskesønn, kan disse beinene leve?
God is asking Ezekiel, is there any hope in this situation?
Så Gud spør Ezekiel, det noe håp I denne situasjonen?
I mean, it looks like a hopeless situation.
Det ser just ut som en helt håpløs situasjon.
The bones are very dry.
For beina så døde.
So God is asking, what do you think, Ezekiel?
Og så Gud sier til Ezekiel, hva tror du?
And I can imagine that as Ezekiel looked upon the dry bones.
Og jeg kan forestille meg at når Ezekiel så på disse døde benene.
All he saw was problems.
Så var alt han kunne se problemer.
But when God looked at the dry bones.
Men når Gud så på disse døde benene.
He saw an army that he wanted to resurrect for his glory.
Så han en hær som han kunne gjenopprette til sin ære.
And in a similar way, when my mom looked at me.
Og på samme måte var det når moren min så på meg.
She saw a problem child.
Så hun et problembarn.
But when God looked at me,
men når Gud så på meg,
instead of seeing a problem child, he saw a potential preacher.
Så han ikke et problembarn, men en potensiell taler.
So can these bones live, Ezekiel?
Så kan disse beinene leve, Ezekiel?
Ezekiel gave the right answer.
Og så det at Ezekiel gir det rette svaret.
He said, O Lord God, thou knowest.
Han sier, å Herre Gud, du vet det.
He didn't say yes in presumption.
Han sa ikke ja I overmot.
Nor did he say no in doubt.
Og han sa heller ikke nei I tvil.
He simply put the situation in the hands of God.
Han bare ga situasjonen over I Guds hender.
And he acknowledged and said, Lord, I don't know, but you know.
Og han anerkjente at Herre, jeg vet ikke, men det gjør jo du.
And when he placed this impossible situation in God's hands.
Og når han la denne umulige situasjonen I Guds hender.
God was able to resurrect an army from the dry bones.
Så var Gud I stand til å reise opp en hel hær fra disse døde benene.
My friends, you might be surrounded in a valley of dry bones tonight.
Og venner, det kan være at du befinner deg I en dal av døde ben I dag.
You might be facing bankruptcy or financial troubles.
Kanskje har du finansielle problemer.
Your marriage is in disarray and you're facing divorce, perhaps.
Kanskje ekteskapet ditt I et fryktelig tilstand,
maybe
og du ferdig med å bli skilt.
Maybe you have children that are acting crazy.
Kanskje har du barn som oppfører seg som de gale.
Or you've been diagnosed with cancer or diabetes or some kind of illness.
Eller kanskje har du blitt diagnostisert med kreft eller diabetes
maybe
eller
noe annet. Maybe you're a young person struggling with school.
Eller kanske är du en ung person som sliter på skolan.
And it feels hopeless like a valley of dry bones.
Och det känns hopplöst som en dal av törre ben.
You put that situation in God's hands.
Lägg den situationen.
You may not know what to do.
Det kan hända att du inte vet vad du ska göra.
But just say to God, Lord, you know.
Men bara se Gud.
And when we trust in God, notice what he does with the dry bones.
Och när vi stoler på Gud, se vad han gör med dessa döda ben.
In Proverbs chapter 3 verses 5 through 8.
I Ordspråken 3:5-8.
It's a very familiar verse. It says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart."
Så står det stol på Herren med hela ditt hjärta.
And lean not unto thine own understanding.
Och lita inte på din egen förstånd.
In all your ways acknowledge him.
Anerkänn han på alla dina vägar.
And he will direct your path.
Och så ska han leda din sti rätt.
Be not wise in your own eyes.
Icke vara vis i dina egna ögon.
Fear the Lord and depart from evil.
Frykt Gud och vänd dig bort från det onda.
And it shall be health to thy navel and marrow to thy bones.
Och det ska bli hälsa för din navle. Og marg til dine ben.
Friends, when we trust in God and not lean on our own understanding.
Vänner, när vi stoler på Gud och inte på vår egen förstånd.
When we say like Ezekiel said, Lord, I don't know, but you know.
När vi säger, jag vet inte Gud, men du vet.
We're basically putting the situation in God's hands.
Så är det att vi lägger situationen I Guds händer.
And we're giving God the opportunity to bring marrow to the bones.
Och vi ger Gud möjlighet till att bringa marg till benen.
So God was about to make his move.
Och det var det Gud var I färd med att göra.
I was 14 years old at the time.
Jag var 14 år gammal på denna tiden.
And here's what happened next.
Och så var det
My mother and I were watching television one day.
Så var det slik att mor min och mig vi så på TV en dag.
We saw an advertisement for a Bible prophecy seminar.
Och så såg vi att det var avertert en sån här möteserie om Bibeln.
How many have heard of something like that before?
Hur många har hört om det någon gång för en möteserie om Bibeln?
The series of evangelistic meetings.
Det var en sån evangelisk möteserie.
We've never really gone to church before.
Och vi hade ju aldrig varit I kyrka förr.
And she was interested.
Och så var hon intresserad.
And she asked me, "Do you want to go?"
Och så sa hon, "Har du lust att komma?"
I said, "No, I don't want to go to that."
Och så sa hon, "Nej, nej."
But my mom still brought me to the meeting.
Men så tog modern min mig likväl med till mötena.
She forced me to go.
Hon tvingat mig faktiskt till att gå.
Young people, if your parents force you to go to church?
Unga människor, hvis föräldrarna deras tvingar dig till att gå till kyrka?
You should praise God.
Så skulle dere prisa Gud.
My mom brought me to the feet of Jesus.
För modern min tog mig med till Jesu fötter.
As she herself was coming to Christ.
I det hon själv kom till Kristus.
And as we attended those meetings about an hour away from our home.
Och I det vi deltog på dessa möten cirka en timme från hemmet vårt.
I heard the teachings of the Bible for the first time.
Så hörte jag det Bibeln hade att säga för första gången.
I was confronted with the prophetic evidence that we can trust the message of the Bible.
Och jag blev konfronterad med det profetiska bevis som tillsa att vi kan stole på Bibeln.
And the truth made sense.
Och sannheten, den stämde. Och jag är så tacksam,
vänner. The Bible is not only beautiful, it's also logical.
För att Bibeln inte bara är vacker, men den är också logisk.
I believe that the biblical worldview.
Jag tror att det bibliska världensbilden.
Is the thinking person's worldview.
Är den tänkande persons världensbilden.
It is absolutely beautiful.
Det är bara vackert.
And intellectually stimulating.
Och det stimulerar också intellektet.
And as a 14-year-old, I was able to comprehend the concepts.
Och som en 14-åring så klarte jag faktiskt att förstå det som blev sagt.
And I saw the evidence why we can believe in the Bible.
Och jag såg bevisen för varför vi kan stole på Bibeln.
And as the result of those meetings.
Och som ett resultat av dessa mötena.
My mother and I were baptized.
Så blev mor min och jag döpt.
But don't say amen too quickly.
Men inte säg amen för fort.
Because when I was baptized that first time.
För när jag blev döpt den första gången.
I went into the water a dry devil.
Så gick jag in I vattnet som en törr djävul.
And I came out of the water a wet devil.
Och så kom jag ut av vattnet som en våt djävul.
There was no change or transformation in my life.
Det var faktiskt ingen förändring I hjärtat mitt.
The reason why is because I believed intellectually.
Grunden var att jag trodde sån med huvudet.
But I didn't understand the true surrender of the life to God.
Men jag förstod inte hur jag verkligen kunde överge livet till Gud.
I did not understand what true belief was.
Jag förstod inte vad sann tro var.
I thought to myself, as long as I understand these things and believe it in my mind, that I'm saved.
Jag trodde att så länge jag förstår dessa ting rent intellektuellt, så är jag
friends,
frälst.
Salvation is not found in what we know.
Men vänner, frälsen är inte grundlagt på vad vi vet.
It is found in who we know.
Den är grundlagt på vem vi
I
känner.
I knew about Jesus.
Jag kände till Jesus.
But I did not know Jesus.
Men jag kände inte Jesus.
I did not surrender my whole heart to him.
Jag överlät inte mitt hela hjärta till han.
Here's what happened.
Och så är det som skedde efter
följande. Let's read verse 4.
Låt oss först läsa vers 4.
Ezekiel 37 verse 4. Here's what happened.
Ezekiel 37:4.
And he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones and say to them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord.
Igen talade han till mig, profeter till dessa ben och säg till dem, dere törre ben, hör Herrens ord.
Thus saith the Lord God unto these bones.
Så säger Herren Gud till dessa ben.
Behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and you shall live.
Sannelig, jeg skal la det komme ånd inn I dere, og dere skal leve.
I will lay sinews upon you and bring up flesh upon you and cover you with skin.
Jeg vil feste sene på dere og la det komme kjøtt på dere.
I will put breath in you and you shall live and you shall know that I am the Lord.
Dekke dere med hud og ta og la det komme ånd I dere, og dere skal vite at jeg Herren.
So I prophesied as I was commanded.
Så profeterte jeg slik jeg var blitt befalt.
And as I prophesied there was a noise and behold a shaking.
Mens jeg profeterte kom det en lyd
and
og de ristet.
The bones came together, bone to his bone.
Og beina trakk seg nær hverandre, hvert bein so, look, nærmere notice, til hverandre.
Ezekiel preaches to the dry bones.
Så her ser vi at Ezekiel faktisk forkynner til de døde beina.
And as the word of the Lord is being spoken.
Og I det Guds ord blir forkynt.
All of a sudden those dry bones come together.
Så begynner de her døde beina å komme sammen.
There's a form that is being developed.
Og det noe som noe former seg til.
And when I went to those meetings and I heard the word of the Lord.
Og når jeg dro på disse møtene og hørte Herrens ord.
That's what was happening to me.
Så var det det som skjedde I meg.
The truth made sense.
Sannheten liksom stemte.
It was logical and I could understand it.
Den var logisk og jeg kunne forstå den.
And the bones were coming together.
Og beina kom sammen.
There was a form of godliness.
Det var en gudfryktighetens form.
But there was something very important that was lacking.
Men det var noe veldig viktig som manglet.
What was that?
Og hva var det?
Notice verse 8.
Legg merke til vers 8.
It says, and when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came upon them.
Jeg så, se, det kom sener og kjøtt på dem.
The skin covered them, but there was no breath in them.
Og det kom hud som dekket dem. Men det var ikke ånd I dem.
So the bones were together.
Så her beina kommet sammen.
But there was still no life because there was still no breath.
Men så det ikke noe liv, for det ikke noe pust.
I was baptized that first time.
Jeg ble døpt den første gangen.
The bones came together.
Det var som om beina kom sammen.
But I was still spiritually dead because I was missing the breath of life.
Men jeg var fremdeles åndelig død fordi at jeg manglet det åndelige pustet.
What does that breath represent?
Og hva det denne pusten representerer?
It represents the spirit of God.
Det representerer Guds ånd.
And for the next 2 years, we started to go to church.
Og I de neste par årene så begynte vi å gå I kirka.
We attended
kirka.
Almost every Sabbath.
Vi kom I kirka omtrent hver eneste
There was
sabbat.
Somewhat of an outward change in my life.
Og utvendig så forandret jeg meg litt.
But inwardly, I was still the same person.
Men på innsiden så var jeg egentlig den samme.
And I had actually an interest in sharing what I knew to be true with my friends in high school.
Og jeg var faktisk interessert I å dele det som jeg visste var sant med vennene mine der på skolen.
I would try to witness to them.
Jeg prøvde å vitne til dem.
And they would look at me.
Og så så de på meg.
You're spiritual now, huh?
Og så sa de, du blitt åndelig du nå da?
And they would ask me, well, why are you still smoking weed?
Og så sa de, hvorfor røyker du fortsatt marihuana da?
You see, I was doing my own thing, even though I was professing Christ.
Fordi jeg gjorde det jeg selv ville, selv om jeg bekjente Kristus.
And I told them, you know, I'm not going to touch the chemical stuff, just the natural stuff.
Og så sa han, jeg skal ikke røre det kjemiske, jeg tar bare de naturlige greiene.
Because when I smoke weed, I can spiritualize and philosophize and I can think deep thoughts.
Fordi jeg sa at når jeg røyker marihuana, da kan jeg filosofere og tenke åndelige dype tanker.
And I would even quote the Bible.
Og jeg siterte til og med Bibelen
to rationalize my sin.
For å rasjonalisere synden min.
I'll tell them.
Jeg sa for eksempel
Genesis chapter 1 says
I første Mosebok kapittel 1 står det
that God has given to man every herb yielding seed.
At Gud har gitt menneskene hver eneste plante som bærer frø.
So I would twist the word of God to justify what I wanted to do.
Så jeg ändra på Guds ord för att få det till att passa till det jag gjorde.
Really I was just burning up my brain cells.
Men egentligen så satt jag egentligen bara hjärncellerna mina upp I
huvudet. That's how deceived I was.
Det är så förfört som jag var.
Notice what else the dry bones represent.
Lägg märke till vad ellers de döda benen representerar.
In Matthew 23:27.
I Matteus 23:27.
Jesus tells us here that the dry bones
så berättar Jesus oss att de döda benen
are a symbol of hypocrisy.
De et symbol på hyckleri.
Speaking to the religious leaders.
Han taler til de religiøse lederne.
He said that you are like whited sepulchres full of dead men's bones.
Og så sier han at dere som hvitkalkede graver fulle av døde mens ben.
Looking good and spiritual on the outside.
Dere ser gode og åndelige ut på utsiden.
But nothing but dry bones on the inside.
Men det ikke noe annet enn døde ben på innsiden.
That was me, friends. I was a lukewarm Christian.
Og det var sånn jeg var, venner. Jeg var en lunken kristen.
I was half-hearted and double-minded.
Jeg var halvhjertet og tvesinnet.
Trying to serve God on one side and yet living for myself on the other side.
Jeg prøvde å tjene Gud på den ene siden, men meg selv på den andre siden.
A whited sepulchre full of bones.
En hvitkalket grav full av døde ben.
And this verse never really impacted me until a few years ago I got the chance to go to India.
Dette verset gjorde ikke så særlig inntrykk på meg før noen få år siden når jeg dro til India.
We held some meetings there.
Og der hadde vi noen møter.
And our last day in India.
Og i den siste dagen når vi var i India.
I got the chance to go visit my palace in India.
Så fikk jeg mulighet til å besøke
The Taj Mahal.
mitt palass, det som heter Taj.
This is the building that I was named after.
Det den bygningen som jeg ble oppkalt etter.
Now I'm not Indian.
Og jeg ikke indisk.
Even though I have an Indian name.
Selv om jeg har et indisk navn.
I'm actually a European. Did you know that?
Jeg faktisk europeisk, visste dere det?
My grandmother is from Germany.
Bestemora mi fra Tyskland.
She's 100% German.
Hun 100% tysk.
Blonde hair and blue eyes.
Hun har lyst hår og blå øyne.
I'm German, Mexican and Filipino.
Så jeg tysk, meksikansk og filippinsk.
But born and raised in Hawaii.
Men jeg født og oppvokst i Hawaii.
With an Indian name.
Med et indisk navn.
So I try to be all things to all men.
Så jeg prøver å være alt for alle mennesker.
When my mom was pregnant with me.
Når moren min var gravid med meg.
She saw a poster of the Taj Mahal.
Så så hun en plakat med den her helligdommen.
She said, that's a beautiful building and that's a nice name and so here I am today.
Og så sa hun, det et fin bygning og det hørtes ut som et fint navn og her jeg i dag.
But when I went to the Taj Mahal for the first time.
Men når jeg reiste til Taj Mahal for første gang.
It was so beautiful on the outside.
Så var det så vakkert på utsiden.
You know what the Taj Mahal is?
Vet dere hva Taj Mahal er?
It's a whited sepulchre full of dead man's bones.
Det en hvitkalket grav full av døde menns ben.
It looks so beautiful on the outside.
Det ser så fint ut på utsiden.
But on the inside is nothing but emptiness.
Men på innsiden så det ingenting annet enn tomhet.
And the dry bones of the king and his wife that he made this building for.
Og de døde benene av den kongen som bygde denne bygningen.
That was a condition of my life.
Det var tilstanden i mitt liv.
I was blind but now I can see, huh?
Jeg var blind men nå kan jeg se.
I was spiritually blind to my condition.
Jeg var åndelig blind for min tilstand.
I thought that because I was going to church, I was safe.
Og jeg trodde at fordi jeg gikk i kirka, så var jeg frelst.
Because I knew the truth and what day the Sabbath was, I would be all right.
Og fordi at jeg kjente til sannheten og hvilken dag det var sabbat, så var det ok.
A whited sepulchre full of dead men's bones.
En hvitkalket grav full av døde menns ben.
And I was so deceived, friends.
Og jeg var så forført, venner.
That I thought I could have both.
Så jeg trodde at jeg kunne ha begge deler.
If you look into those eyes,
hvis du ser inn i disse øynene,
there's no life in those eyes.
Så det ikke noe liv i dem.
I was constantly stimulated.
Jeg var hele tiden stimulert.
But I was never satisfied.
Men aldri tilfredsstilt.
An outward form of godliness.
En utvortes form for Guds frykt.
But spiritually dead on the inside.
Men åndelig død på innsiden.
Maybe this evening you can relate with that.
Og kanskje i kveld kan du relatere til det.
You know, sometimes we come to meetings like these.
For noen ganger så kommer vi til møter som det her.
We look spiritual on the outside.
Og vi ser åndelig ut på utsiden.
But there's something missing on the inside.
Men det som om det noe som mangler på innsiden.
And while we can fool others.
Og mens vi kan holde andre for narr.
We can't fool God.
Så kan vi ikke holde Gud for
narr. He reads our life like an open book.
Han leser livene våre som en åpen
He knows the deepest, darkest secrets of our lives.
Og han vet de dypeste, mørke hemmelighetene i vårt liv.
But here's the beautiful thing, friends.
Men her kommer det vakre, venner.
The one that knows us the very best.
Den som kjenner oss aller best.
Is the one that loves us the very most.
Den som elsker oss aller mest.
Sometimes I would even go to church high.
Och någon gånger så gick jag till och med i menigheten
som sinning in the very presence of God.
I menigheten berusad I Guds närvaro.
God still looked upon me with eyes of infinite love.
Och likväl så såg Gud på mig med ögon som lyste av evig kärlek.
And operations were set in motion for my salvation.
Och det var ting som började att bli satt I verk för min frälsning.
I was reading the Bible one morning.
Jag läste Bibeln en morgon.
And I had the word of God in one hand.
Jag hade Guds ord I en hand.
And in the other hand I had the glass pipe.
Och I den andra handen så hade jag glasspipa.
I was reading the Bible and getting high at the same time.
Så jag läste Bibeln och så blev jag hög på narkotika på den andra sidan.
But I wasn't comprehending anything I was reading.
Men jag kände självklart ingenting av det jag läste.
And in that moment it was as if the Spirit of God said.
Och I det ögonblicket så var det som om Herrens ande sa.
Taj, who are you fooling?
Taj, vem det du lurer?
What makes you think you could have me and the world at the same time?
Vad som får dig att tro att du kan ha världen och mig samtidigt?
It's either one or the other.
Det är enten den ene eller den andra.
Either the weed of death or the word of life.
Enten dödens ugräs eller livets ord.
For Jesus said no man can serve two masters.
För Jesus säger att ingen kan tjäna två herrar.
It's either Jesus is lord of all or he's not lord at all.
Enten så är Jesus herre över allt eller så är han inte herre I det hela.
It's either we're going to be saved or we're going to be lost.
Enten blir du frälst eller så går du förtappt.
There is no neutrality in spirituality.
Det är inte något neutralt I andlighet.
We're on one side or the other, friends.
Enten är vi på den ena sidan eller den andra, vänner.
And if we are almost saved.
Och hvis vi är nästan frälst.
We are still completely lost.
Så är vi likväl fullständigt förtappt.
And friends, what a tragedy to be so close.
Och vilken tragedi är det vänner att vara så nära?
And yet so far at the same time.
Och likväl så långt borta på samma tid.
I was lost in the church.
Jag var förtappt I menigheten.
But in my heart of hearts there was a longing for something more.
Men djupt I hjärtat mitt så var det en längtan efter något mer.
And I remember coming home one night.
Och jag husker att en kväll så kom jag hem.
After a night of partying.
Efter att jag hade festat en kväll.
I went into my bedroom.
Och så gick jag in på rummet mitt.
It was dark, quiet.
Det var mörkt och stille.
There was no music to distract my thoughts.
Ikke noe musikk som kunne avlede tankene.
And the darkness and quietness of that bedroom.
Og I mørket og stillheten der på soverommet.
Reflected the darkness and the emptiness of my life.
Så følte jeg at det reflekterte mørket og tomheten I mitt
liv. I had fun at the party.
Jeg hadde hatt det morsomt på festen.
But I went into that bedroom afterwards. It was nothing but emptiness.
Men når jeg kom inn på rommet etterpå, så var det ingenting annet enn tomhet.
I felt so far away from God.
Jeg følte meg så langt borte fra Gud.
On my nightstand was a book called Steps to Christ.
Og på nattbordet mitt så var det en bok som het
You heard that book before?
Veien til Kristus.
How many of you read that book?
Hvor mange har lest den
boken? Oh, that's a powerful book.
Det en fantastisk
bok. I picked up the book.
Og så tok jeg opp boken.
I didn't read it.
Och läste den inte.
I just read the title Steps to Christ.
Jag läste bara titeln Vägen till Kristus.
And I was convicted that I wasn't taking steps to Christ.
Och så var jag obevist om att jag var inte på vägen till Kristus.
I was taking steps to church.
Jag var på vägen till kyrkan.
But not to Christ.
Men inte till Kristus.
I was running away from Christ in my heart.
Jag löp väck från Kristus I hjärtat mitt.
And on the cover of that book Steps to Christ.
Och på försidan av den boken Vägen till Kristus.
Was this beautiful picture of Jesus with his arms open in invitation.
Så var det ett vackert bild av Jesus hvor han hade händerna öppna och liksom inviterade mig.
And I was convicted that even though I was doing these terrible things.
Och jag blev överbevist om att även om jag gjorde dessa fruktliga tingene.
Jesus was still calling, inviting me to come to him.
Så inviterade Jesus mig likväl och kallade mig till han.
During that time my mom was praying for me.
Och på den tiden så bad modern min för mig.
Parents don't stop praying for your kids.
Föräldrar, stopp aldrig att be för barnen.
When she found the marijuana in my room.
Hun fant marihuana I rommet mitt.
She was so upset about it.
Hun ble så sint.
She didn't know what to do.
Så lei seg. Hun visste ikke hva hun skulle gjøre.
But she prayed.
Men da ba hun.
And I stand before you here this evening because my mom prayed for me.
Og jeg står her foran dere I kveld fordi moren min ba for meg.
Parents, you have young people that are lost.
Foreldre, hvis dere har barn som fortapt.
Keep praying.
Fortsett å be.
One day you're going to see those young people stand up and testify to the goodness of God.
En dag så vil dere se disse unge stå og bekjenne Guds trofasthet.
Here's what happened next.
Og så skjedde det.
Notice verse 9.
Som det står her I vers 9.
Then he said unto me, prophesy unto the wind, prophesy son of man.
Han sa profeter menneskesønn.
And say to the wind,
Och si till vinden.
Thus saith the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain that they may live.
Verse
9.
Da sa han til meg, profeter til ånden, profeter menneskesønn, og si til ånden, så sier Herren Gud, kom fra de fire vindretninger, du ånd, og pust på disse drepte, så de kan leve.
So there was a form of a body, but no life.
Så det var et slags legeme, men ikke noe liv.
Because they needed the wind or the breath of God.
Fordi de trengte denne her ånden, eller pustet fra Gud.
And that's what I was missing.
Og det var det som jeg ikke hadde.
God saw it, so he sent two young people to come and knock on my door.
Og det så Gud, og derfor så beveget han noen unge mennesker til å komme og banke på
døren.
Og de inviterte meg til nok en evangelisk møteserie.
When I went to those meetings,
og når jeg gikk til de møtene,
the theme song sung every night was the song Change My Heart, O God.
Så var temasangen som ble sunget hver kveld, den sa Forandr hjertet mitt, Gud.
And as I sat there listening to the power of the word of God,
og i det jeg satt der og lyttet til kraften I Guds ord,
listening to that song, Change My Heart, O God,
og hørte på denne sangen, Forandr hjertet mitt, Gud,
God was breathing into my dead soul His life-giving breath.
Så pustet Gud inn I mitt døde hjerte sitt livgivende pust.
And I realized I wasn't missing the theory of truth. I was missing the person of truth.
Og jeg fant ut at jeg manglet ikke sannhetens teori, men den personen som sannheten.
I needed God to change my heart.
Jeg trengte at Gud skulle forandre hjertet mitt.
But the devil was attacking.
Men djevelen angrep.
And yet, even though there was an internal struggle in my mind,
og selv om det var en slik stor indre kamp I mitt liv,
I continued to go to those meetings.
Så fortsatte jeg å gå til disse møtene.
It doesn't matter how you come. What matters is that you come.
Det ikke alt. Det handler egentlig ikke om hvordan du kommer, men at du kommer.
Victory is found in simply showing up.
Du får seier når du fortsetter å gå.
And God worked in my life.
Og Gud virket I livet mitt.
I remember one night specifically, the evangelist made a call.
Og jeg husker spesielt en kveld hvor evangelisten gjorde et alterkall.
For people to come and make a decision for baptism.
Og han sa, de som ville kunne komme opp og bestemme seg for
dåp. The devil was telling me every reason why I shouldn't come.
Og djevelen sa alle mulige grunner til hvorfor jeg ikke skulle komme.
He said to me, if you give your life to Jesus, your friend's gonna think you're weak.
Han sa, hvis du gir livet ditt til Jesus, så kommer vennene dine til å føle at du en svekling.
If you surrender to God, your life is gonna be boring.
Hvis du gir livet ditt til Gud, så kommer det til å bli kjedelig.
You can't live right because you're an addict.
Du kan jo ikke leve sånn for Gud, for du jo avhengig av disse tingene.
The devil was whispering all those lies in my ear.
Djevelen hvisket alle disse løgnene I ørene mine.
But God was calling me to come as I was.
Men Gud kalte meg til å komme som jeg var.
And that night I found myself at the altar weeping.
Og den kvelden så fant jeg meg selv foran alteret.
Crying out to God, saying, Lord, if you're there and if you're real.
Hvor jeg gråt og ropte ut til Gud, hvis du der, og hvis du virkelig riktig,
I want to receive you into my life.
Så vil jeg at du skal komme inn I mitt liv.
I want to be a servant of yours.
Jeg ønsker å være din tjener.
But I recognize I can't serve you and continue to do these terrible things in my life.
Men jeg ser at jeg kan ikke fortsette å tjene deg og samtidig gjøre disse tingene I livet mitt.
I need you to take away the addictions.
Jeg trenger at du må ta vekk alle disse avhengighetsforholdene
jeg har. Take away the drugs and the desire for it.
Ta vekk narkotikaen og den lysten jeg har til det.
And when I prayed that prayer sincerely with all my heart.
Og når jeg ba den bønnen oppriktig med hele hjertet mitt.
The Lord took it from me.
Så tok Herren det fra meg.
It didn't take a week, not even a few days.
Det tok ikke noen dager, det tok ikke en uke.
That very night the Lord made me free from that lifestyle.
Den kvelden gjorde Herren meg fri fra livsstilen.
He gave me a peace and a joy I'd never experienced before.
Og han gir meg en glede og en fred som jeg aldri har opplevd tidligere.
Up to that point I was stimulated.
Inntil det punktet så hadde jeg blitt stimulert ved nytelsen I synd.
When I met Jesus,
men når jeg møtte Jesus,
personally for the first time,
personlig for første gang,
then that I experienced true satisfaction.
Så var det at jeg følte meg virkelig tilfredsstilt.
God filled the emptiness of my life.
Jeg følte ikke den her tomheten av livet mitt.
And at the end of those meetings,
og ved slutten av disse møtene,
I was then baptized the second time.
Så ble jeg døpt for andre gang.
And now you can say amen.
Og nå kan dere si amen.
Because that second baptism was really the first real baptism.
For den andre dåpen var egentlig den første riktige dåpen.
I gave my life fully to God.
For jeg ga livet mitt fullt til Herren.
And then God began to restore the years that the locusts had eaten.
Og så begynte Gud å gjenopprette de årene som gresshoppene hadde
spist. As I got into the word.
Og det jeg gravde inn I ordet.
God began to restore all those burnt brain cells.
Så begynte Gud å gjenopprette alle disse tapte hjernecellene.
He started giving me wisdom and understanding.
Han begynte å gi meg visdom og forstand.
You see, before that I was getting straight Fs in high school.
For før dette her så fikk jeg noe som heter F. Det betyr antageligvis at man har feilet.
It doesn't stand for fantastic.
F betyr ikke fantastisk.
It was failure.
Det betyr at du har feilet.
But God started restoring my mind.
Men Gud begynte å gjenopprette sinnet mitt.
So from having straight F's, I was getting straight A's.
Og fra å få F, så fikk jeg A.
He was restoring the years that the locust had eaten.
Han gjenopprettet de årene som gresshoppen hadde spist opp.
In my heart a burning desire to share his love with others.
Og han la i hjertet mitt en brennende iver etter å dele hans kjærlighet
med andre. So I started witnessing to my family and friends.
Og så begynte jeg å vitne til familien og vennene mine.
I started sharing the truths that I had understood.
Jeg begynte å dele de sannhetene som jeg hadde forstått.
Here's what happened. Notice verse 10.
Her det som skjedde. Legg merke til vers 10.
So I prophesied as he commanded me and the breath came into them and they lived.
Så profeterte jeg slik han befalte meg. Da kom ånden inn I dem, og de ble levende.
And stood upon their feet an exceeding great army.
Og de sto på føttene en hær som var meget, meget stor.
When the life of God came into me,
når Guds liv kom inn I meg,
I enrolled as a soldier in the army of the Lord.
Så bestemte jeg meg for å være soldat I Herrens hær.
As I was 16 years old.
Jeg var 16 år gammel da.
I went back to my public high school.
Og jeg gikk tilbake til skolen jeg
gikk på. People knew me as a chronic and a stony boy.
Hvor de kjente meg som en ganske umulig gutt.
Always cutting class and fooling around.
Som alltid avbrøt I klassen og tullet og tøyset.
And I would pass steps to Christ out to all my friends.
Og nå gikk jeg og delte veien til Kristus ut til alle vennene mine.
I would have Bible studies every lunch period.
Og hver eneste gang når det var pause så hadde jeg bibelstudie med dem.
And I would invite the whole school to come to lead out in the Bible to listen to the Bible studies that I was leading out in.
Og så inviterte jeg hele skolen til å komme til de bibelstudiene som jeg ledet ut I.
And as a result of those Bible studies,
og som et resultat av disse bibelstudiene,
6 of my friends and their family members were baptized too.
Så var det 6 av mine venner og deres familier som ble døpt også.
God was restoring the years that the locust had eaten, all that negative influence.
Gud gjenopprettet de årene som gresshoppen hadde spist, all den innflytelsen jeg hadde utøvet.
And my friends would try to tempt me.
Og vennene mine prøvde å friste meg.
Offer me drugs.
Og de prøvde å tilby meg narkotika.
Tell them no thanks, I found a better high.
Og jeg sa nei, jeg har funnet noe som gjør meg enda mer høy.
I found the most high.
Jeg har funnet den aller høyeste.
And they were listening with open ears.
Og de lyttet med åpne ører.
I also had the opportunity to preach.
Jeg hadde også muligheten til å tale.
My first sermon when I was 16 years old.
Min første tale når jeg var 16 år gammel.
The main service on Sabbath morning.
Det var hovedgudstjenesten sabbat morgen.
Now the pastor took a risk.
Og da tok pastoren han tok en liten sjanse.
I was so excited to have that opportunity.
Men jeg var så glad for å ha den muligheten.
And you should have heard that first sermon.
Og dere skulle ha hørt den første talen.
It was absolutely terrible.
Det var fryktelig.
I wasn't making sense because my English wasn't so good.
Den ga egentlig ikke mye mening for jeg hadde ikke særlig god engelsk.
Because you see, English is my second language.
For engelsk mitt andre språk.
My first language is broken English.
Mitt første språk broken English, altså dårlig engelsk.
My vocabulary was very small.
Og mitt ordforråd var veldig lite.
And so even though it wasn't eloquent.
Men selv om det ikke var særlig godt språk.
Even though there was a lot of stuttering.
Selv om det var mye stamming.
People were still blessed because they saw the excitement in my life.
Så var folk så velsignet for de så iveren I livet mitt.
Here was my experience.
Og her min erfaring.
In the book of Jeremiah chapter 20 and verse 9.
Jeremia 29.
It says, but his word was in my heart as burning fire.
Så står det at hans ord var I hjertet mitt som brennende ild.
Shut up in my bones and I was weary of holding it back and I could not.
Jeg har ikke funnet det enda, men. Som var lukket inne I meg, og jeg kunne ikke holde det tilbake.
The Lord set me on fire then.
Herren tente meg I brand.
And by the grace of God, I'm still on fire today.
Og Guds nåde, så jeg enda I brand
I
dag.
Never needs to die out, friends.
Branden, ilden behøver aldri å dø ut.
The fire should only grow brighter and brighter and hotter every single day.
Ilden skulle bare bli sterkere og sterkere og varmere hver dag.
I didn't care what other people thought about me.
Og jeg brød meg ikke om hva andre trodde om meg.
All that matters what God thought about me.
Alt som betydde noe for meg var hva Gud trodde om meg.
I wasn't ashamed of the gospel.
Og jeg var ikke redd for evangeliet.
And I felt the Lord was calling me into ministry.
Jeg følte at Herren kalte meg inn I predikanttjenesten.
My last year of high school, I transferred from the public school to the Christian Academy.
Og siste året der på videregående, kanskje high school, så gikk jeg fra å gå I offentlig skole til en kristen skole.
And in Hawaii Mission Academy, I met a lot of nice friends.
Og på Hawaii Mission Academy så møtte jeg mange gode venner.
And I met this really nice girl.
Och så mötte jag den här jenta här som var väldigt grej.
She was a Christian young lady that loved the Lord.
Det var en ung kristen jente som älskade Herren.
And she believed just like I believed.
Och hon trodde akkurat det samma som jag trodde.
She would go to church and she had an experience with God.
Och hon gick i kyrka och hon hade en erfaring med Gud.
I was attracted to the Jesus living in her.
Och jag var så tilltrukket av Jesus som levde i henne.
We started a relationship.
Och så började vi att vara samman.
Different from the other relationships I had in the past.
Och det var så annorledes än de jag hade varit samman för.
And upon graduating from academy.
Och idag var färdig på videregående.
She felt called to go to a Bible college in the dry desert of Arizona.
Så följde hon kallt till att resa till Arizona, där det är så tört för att gå på bibelskola.
And so because she went, you know, I had to go too.
Och du vet, sedan hon drog så måste jag också dra.
And we were there in the Bible college for 2 years.
Och där var vi på bibelskolan i 2 år.
Getting more training to be more effective servants of the Lord.
Och fick mer träning i hur vi kunde arbeta effektivt för Herren.
But to make a long story longer.
Och för att göra en lång historia längre.
After graduating from that Bible college, I ended up marrying my high school sweetheart.
Efter att vi graduerade från den bibelskolan så gifte jag mig med henne jag var glad i.
We've been married almost 13 years now.
Och nu har vi varit gift i nästan 13 år.
And we're a team in ministry.
Och vi är verkligen ett team i missionstjänsten.
God then opened the doors for us to become conference evangelists in Central California Conference.
Och så öppnade Gud möjligheten för att vi kunde vara evangelister för konferensen.
And we had conducted over 70 seminars.
Och vi har haft mer än 70 seminarier.
Mostly in California but all over the world.
För det mesta i Kalifornien men egentligen över hela världen.
God was restoring the years that the locusts had eaten.
Gud genopprättade de åren som gräshoppen hade
fått. He took us to Africa and Asia and Europe.
Han tog oss till Afrika, Asien och Europa.
Opening incredible doors of opportunity to make an impact on people's lives for eternity.
Öppna fantastiska dörrar för att vi kunna ha inverkning på människors hjärtan för evigheten.
And I can't think of anything better to do.
Och jag kan inte komma på något bättre att göra.
Than by the grace of God to change people's eternal destinies.
Än med Guds nåde och hjälpa till med att ändra människors eviga skäbne.
There's nothing special with me.
Men vänner, det är inte något som är speciellt med mig.
I'm just a beggar trying to share some bread.
Jag är bara en som att be, alltså en tigger som delar bröd.
And Jesus and his word is the bread of life. Amen.
Och Jesus är livets bröd.
But here's the thing, friends, if God can use someone like me.
Men här är det, vänner. Hvis Gud kan bruka en som mig.
He can use anybody. Amen.
Så kan han bruka vem som helst, ikke sant?
We just have to have a willing heart.
Vi må bare ha et villig hjerte.
And God will do powerful things in our lives and through our lives.
Og så vil Gud gjøre mektige ting i våre liv og gjennom våre liv.
The Lord has blessed us to see over 1200 people baptized through our meeting.
Gud har velsignet oss med å se mer enn 1200 mennesker døpt gjennom møteserien
vår. We've seen many marriages being restored.
Vi har sett många äktenskap som har blivit genopprättade.
The chains of addiction broken.
Vi har sett hurdan avhängighetens länkar
har blivit brutna. Young people come alive for Christ.
Vi har sett hurdan unga människor har kommit till liv igen.
As the Lord has taken us around the world.
I det Herren har tagit oss runt omkring i världen.
On this amazing adventure of faith.
På detta fantastiska troens resa.
The Bible tells us.
Och Bibeln berättar oss.
That the work of the final Elijah generation.
Att det sista arbetet som Elia generation ska göra.
Is to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, the hearts of the children to the fathers.
Det är att vända fädernas hjärtan till barna och barnas hjärtan till fäderna.
Reconciliation in family.
Det är genupprättelser av familjer.
Let me just share these few last stories before we close.
Jag lyssnade till en få historier till med er för vi avslutar.
God was restoring the years that the locusts had eaten in my family relationships.
Gud genupprättade de åren som gräshoppen hade ödelagt i min familj.
Growing up in a broken home, my parents were never married.
I det jag växte upp i ett brutet hem så var föräldrarna mina aldrig gift.
But the Lord started to restore that relationship.
Men Herren begynte å gjenopprette det forholdet.
And so after 16 years of living in a divided broken home.
Så efter 16 år som jag hade levt i ett brutet hem.
My mom and my dad actually got back together.
Så kom moren och faren min sammen igen.
And they actually got married for the first time.
Och de blev gift för första gång.
And then 3 years later here comes baby brother.
Och 3 år senare så kom babybrodern min.
Same mom and same dad.
Samma mamma, samma pappa.
After 19 years of being the only child.
Efter 19 år var jag den enda gutten.
Now is no longer alone.
Och nu är jag inte längre alene.
And he doesn't have a Hindu name like I do. He has a biblical name. His name is Micah.
Och han har inte ett hindunamn som jag har. Hans namn är Mika.
Because our God is in the business of restoring family and life. Amen.
For Guds uppgave är att gjenupprätta familjer och
liv. Here's a picture of my grandparents.
Här ett bild av besteföräldrarna mina.
That relationship was a broken, terrible relationship too.
Det var också ett brutt, förfärligt förhåll.
Grandpa had done something wrong against grandma.
Bestefar hade gjort något galt mot bestemor.
Grandma's heart was broken.
Och bestemors hjärta var brutt.
But that pain turned to bitterness.
Och den smärtan
anger
vände sig till bitterhet
and resentment.
Och sinne och lysten till att gengälla.
It's a terrible story of a broken relationship.
Fryktlig historia om ett brutt förhåll.
But then in 2007 I got the chance to do one of our first meetings in the wicked city of San Francisco.
Men i 2007 så höll jag mitt första möte i den onda byn San Francisco.
During that time grandpa was living in San Francisco with one of my aunties.
Och min bestefar bodde i San Francisco med en av tanterna mina.
And grandma was back home in Hawaii.
Och bestemor var hemma i Hawaii.
And because it was close by, my grandpa came to our meetings.
Och för det var så nära vi så kom bestefar på mötet.
Not because he was interested in the Bible.
Inte för det han var intresserad i Bibeln.
He just wanted to hear his grandson stand up and talk in front of people.
Han önskade bara höra den som han var bestefar till som stod och snackade för så många folk.
I thought he would only come once.
Och jag trodde att han bara ville komma en gång.
But he ended up coming every single night.
Men han kom var enaste kväll.
He even came on a night when we didn't have a meeting.
Han kom till och med en kväll då vi inte hade möte.
He didn't realize that we had a night off.
För det han hade inte fått med sig att vi hade en fri
kväll. And he was enjoying the meeting, getting into the word of God for the first time.
Och han var så glad för mötet och gravde in i Guds ord för första gång.
And finally we came to the topic about the God of new beginnings.
Och så kom vi till det tema som handlar om Gud som kan starta oss
på nytt.
And I
made an invitation for people to come to the front to give their hearts to Christ.
Och så inviterade jag människor till att komma fram för att ge deras hjärta till Jesus.
It was one of the greatest blessings of my life.
Och det var en av de största välsignelser i livet mitt.
To see my grandfather, the patriarch of our family.
Och se att bestefar som var patriarken i familjen.
Stand up and walk down the aisle giving his life to Jesus.
Han stod upp och gick fram och gav livet sitt till Jesus.
As a result of hearing his grandson share the word of life.
För det han hörte att den han var bestefar till delte Guds ord.
That grandfather that was there all my life.
Den bestefaren som var där hela livet.
The one that held me when I was a little baby boy.
Den som höll mig när jag var en liten babygutt.
The one that was there when I graduated from high school.
Den som var där när jag graduerade från vidaregående.
At the end of those meetings.
Vid enden av dessa mötena.
I was able to hold him in the waters of baptism.
Så fick jag hålla han i dopens vatten.
As he received a brand new beginning with Jesus.
I det han fick en helt ny begynnelse med Jesus.
Letting God cleanse him of his terrible mistakes.
Och så fick han renselse från sina fryktliga fel.
And with tears in his eyes, he was baptized.
Och med tårar i ögonen så blev han döpt.
I like to say that he held me when I was born, but I held him when he was born again.
Och jag plejer att säga att han höll mig när jag blev född, men jag höll han när han blev enfött.
Who would have thought, friends?
Vilken tanke, vänner?
That God could use the third generation to reach the first generation.
Att Gud kan bruka den tredje generationen för att gjenupprätta den första generationen.
But that's what Jesus can do, friends.
Men det är det Jesus kan göra, vänner.
Turning the hearts of the fathers to the children, the hearts of the children to the fathers.
Han kan vända fädernas hjärta till barnen och barnens hjärta till fädernas.
Grandpa was a new man.
Bestefar var en ny man.
And because of that, he wanted to reconcile with grandma.
Och för det han var blivit en ny man så önskade han att gjenförena sig med bestemor.
And he went and apologized.
Och så drog han och bekände.
Humbled himself before grandma.
Ydmykt sig själv för bestemor.
And pleaded for her.
Och bad om att han må få henne tillbaka.
But grandma's heart was so hard.
Men bestemors hjärta var så hårt.
She could not forgive him.
Att hon kunde inte tillgi han.
She wouldn't believe that he was changed.
Hon kunde inte tro att han hade ändrat sig.
And she continued to rub his past in his face.
Och hon fortsatte och grava upp i fortiden föran han.
2 years go by and grandma still doesn't believe that grandpa is changed.
2 år och bestemor kan inte tro att bestefar har förändrat sig.
And then in 2009.
Och så i 2009.
I went back home to that in Hawaii to that same church I was converted in 10 years before.
Så drog jag tillbaka till Hawaii till den menighet där jag blev omvänd 10 år tidigare.
And I preached my first meeting in my home church.
Och där hade jag den första möteserien i min hemmenighet.
God brought me full circle in 10 years.
Gud hjälpte mig att komma hela cirkeln runt i 10 på 10 år.
During that time, grandma and grandpa were in Hawaii.
Och på den tiden var bestemor och bestefar i Hawaii.
So because it was close by.
Och för det var i närheten.
Grandpa brought grandma to the meetings.
Så tog bestefar bestemor till mötena.
And she came not because she was interested.
Och hon kom inte för det hon var intresserad.
She came because she was guilt-tripped into coming.
Men hon kom för det hon var drivet av skyldfølelse till att komma.
Grandpa said your grandson is speaking. You need to go support your grandson.
Bestefar sa att det är ju barnbarnet ditt som talar så du måste ju gå och stötta barnbarnet ditt.
You know, grandparents they feel obligated, so she was there, but she sat way in the back.
Så besteforeldre de gjør noen ganger ting for det de må.
The furthest away she could sit is where she sat.
Så langt bak som hun kunne sitte satt hun.
I was so happy that she was there.
Og jeg var så glad for at hun var der.
I preached my heart out every night.
Og jeg talte fra hjertet mitt hver kveld.
And as I greeted people at the door when they left.
Og i det jeg hilste på folk ved døren når de gikk ut.
I'd hug my little grandma.
Så klemte jeg den lille bestemoren.
Grandma, thank you for coming. I'm so happy you're here.
Og så sa jeg, kjære bestemor, tusen takk for at du kom. Jeg så glad for at du her.
But her face was angry.
Men ansiktet hennes var sint.
Emotionless.
Uten følelse.
It felt like she wasn't being convicted.
Det føltes som hun ikke var overbevist.
Her heart was hard like a rock.
Hjertet hennes var så hardt som en stein.
She was a slave to bitterness and resentment.
Hun var sånn en slave til bitterhet og vonde følelser.
So I would pray for her.
Og så ba jeg for henne.
And every night preached my heart out.
Og hver eneste kveld så talte jeg rett fra hjertet.
It seemed like nothing was happening in her heart.
Og det så ut som ingenting skjedde i hjertet hennes.
But then we came to the topic of the God of new beginnings.
Men så kom vi til det tema om Gud som kan starte noen på nytt.
The God that can restore the years that the locusts have eaten.
Gud som kan gjenopprette det som gresshoppene har spist.
And I made a call for people to come to the altar.
Og så gjorde jeg et alterkall.
To give their hearts to Jesus in baptism.
For at folk skulle komme frem og gi deres hjerte til Jesus i
dåpen. Over 50 people came to the front.
Mer enn 50 mennesker kom frem.
The tears were flowing and the spirit of God was working.
Og tårene rant og Guds ånd virket.
And as I was preaching, I was overwhelmed with joy seeing all these people to come to Christ.
Og i det jeg talte så var jeg fylt av glede over å se at alle disse menneskene kom
til
Kristus.
I was praising God and so happy.
Jeg priste Gud og jeg var så glad.
Until I saw my grandma.
Inntil jeg så bestemoren min.
Sitting way in the back, sitting there.
Som satt langt bakerst.
She wasn't moving.
Og ikke flyttet på seg.
And I knew that she needed this perhaps the most.
Og jeg visste at hun kanskje trengte det her mest av alle.
And so I said in my mind, Lord, I'm happy for these.
Så jeg sa i hjertet mitt, Herre, jeg glad for
But
de som har
kommet. My own flesh and blood?
Men hva med mitt eget kjød og blod?
Help my grandma to have courage to stand, Lord.
Hjelp bestemor til å ha mot til å stå.
Free her from her bitterness.
Fri henne fra bitterheten.
And I prayed that as I preached.
Og dette ba jeg mens jeg talte.
And I continued to call.
Og så fortsatte jeg bare å gi alt.
She wouldn't move.
Og hun flytta seg ikke.
So I went on and on and on and on.
Så jeg fortsatte og fortsatte og fortsatte.
And finally, after about 10 minutes.
Og til slutt etter omkring 10 minutter.
It was one of the greatest joys of my life.
Så var det en av de største gledene jeg noen gang
har opplevd. To see grandma stand up by herself.
I det jeg så at bestemor reiste seg opp.
And walk down the aisle.
Og gikk fram.
Like a wife walking down the aisle to meet her husband.
Som en kvinne som gikk ned av gulvet for å møte sin mann.
Grandma walked down the aisle to meet Jesus.
Sånn gikk bestemor ned for å møte Jesus.
And at the end of those meetings, I was able to hold her as well in the waters of baptism.
Og etter det møtet så var jeg også i stand til å holde henne i mine armer i dåpen.
God was healing her of that resentful, bitter spirit.
Og Gud, han gjenopprettet henne fra denne her bittre ånden.
Around this time period was my grandparents' 50th wedding anniversary.
Og rundt denne tiden så var det 50 års bryllupsdag for mine besteforeldre.
Because of what God was doing in their lives.
Og på grunn av det Gud gjorde i livene deres.
Guess what they wanted to do for their 50th wedding anniversary.
Hva tror du de hadde lyst til å gjøre på 50 års bryllupsdagen?
They wanted to renew their vows.
Da ville de gjenopprette ekteskapsløftene sine.
So who do you suppose they asked to help with that?
Og hvem tror de spurte om å gjøre det?
So I had the privilege of renewing the vows of my own grandparents.
Och så hade jag privilegiet att vige mina egna besteföräldrar.
Because no matter how broken our lives may be.
För samma hur brutet våra liv har varit.
Our God is a God of new beginnings.
Så är Gud en Gud som startar oss upp på nytt.
He restores the years that the locusts have eaten.
Och som gjenopprettar de åren som gresshopparna har spist upp.
Have you experienced brokenness in your relationships?
Har dere upplevt brutthet i deras förhåll?
Give it to Jesus, friends.
Gi det til Jesus, venner.
God can perform a mighty miracle in your life.
For Gud kan gjøre et mektig mirakel i deres liv.
One last story before we close.
En siste historie før vi slutter.
Now grandma and grandpa are in church together. Amen.
Her bestemor og bestefar i kirka sammen.
But the probably the most difficult person in my family was my auntie Helen.
Men den vanskeligste personen I familien min var nok
When I became a Christian, she would try to argue with me.
När jag blev kristen så började hon att diskutera med mig.
She told me that I was being brainwashed.
Hon fortalade att jag var blivit hjärnvaskad.
She was into the new age stuff.
För hon var inne I det här new age grejerna.
She was a relativist and a pluralist.
Hon var väldigt relativ och hon trodde inte på absoluter.
She didn't believe in moral absolutes. Whatever was right for you may not be right for me. Whatever is wrong for you may not be wrong for me. Kind of attitude.
Det som riktigt för dig kanske inte riktigt för mig, och det som riktigt för mig kanske inte riktigt för dig. Det var så hon tänkte.
And I would try to argue with her, but she would never listen.
Och jag prövade att argumentera med henne, men hon lyssnade inte.
So finally, I decided to shut my mouth and let my life do the talking.
Så till sist så bestämde jag mig för att lukka munnen och låta livet mitt tala.
And about 14 years went by.
Och det tog cirka 14 år.
Before Auntie Helen finally came to our meetings.
För Tante Heather till slut kom till möte.
With an open heart.
Med ett öppet hjärta.
And you can see the conviction on her face.
Och du kan se hur obevist hon är.
And she began to hear the wonderful words of life.
Hon började att höra livets fantastiska ord.
And just not long ago, we also had the privilege of baptizing her.
Och för inte särskilt länge sedan så hade jag det privilegiet att döpa henne.
As she received peace in Jesus.
I det hon fick fred I Jesus.
It took 14 years of prayer.
Det tog 14 år med bön.
But the Lord prevailed. Amen.
Men Herren, han holdt ut.
When Auntie Helen came out of the water.
Og når Tante Helen kom ut av vannet.
My grandpa was there to greet her.
Så var bestefar der for å ta imot henne.
And my grandpa said to Auntie Helen, his daughter.
Og bestefar sa til Tante Helen som var datteren hans.
Helen, my daughter.
Helen, datteren min.
You are now my sister.
Nå du søsteren min.
Because the blood of Jesus makes father and daughter, brother and sister in Christ.
För det att blodet I Kristus gör att far och dotter blir bror och syster I Kristus.
My friends, what God has done in my life is not unusual.
Det som Gud har gjort I livet mitt, det är inte något han bara kan göra I livet mitt.
It's something that he's done for many people.
Det är något han har gjort för många människor.
Each and every one of you have a story.
Och var enaste en av er har en historia.
And our story is being written day by day.
Och historien vår blir skrivet dag för dag.
It is the testimony of Jesus, the great story of redemption.
Det är Jesu vittnesbud. Det är genlösningens historia.
The question is, how will your story end?
Men frågan är, hur vill din historia ända?
My friends, tonight.
Vänner ikväll.
Some of you need a new beginning.
Så är det någon av er som trenger en ny start.
Maybe you can resonate and relate with some of the things from my experience.
Kanske igenkänner du något av det jag fortalt om I min historia.
Maybe you're struggling with some kind of personal addiction in your life.
Kanske kämpar du med någon personlig avhängighet I ditt liv.
And you long to be free.
Och du längtar efter att bli fri.
Jesus can make you free tonight.
Jesus kan göra dig fri ikväll.
Or maybe you're like how I was, going to church.
Eller kanske är du som jag var som gick till menigheten.
But living for self.
Men jag levde för själva.
Taking steps to church but running from Christ.
Jag gick mot menigheten men jag löp väck från Kristus.
Jesus today is calling you for a new beginning.
Och idag så kallar också Jesus på dig
to give your complete heart to him.
Till att ha en ny begynnelse och ge ditt hjärta fullständigt åt
honom. Not just part of your life.
Inte bara lite av livet ditt.
But to give everything.
Men allt.
So that he can make you free and wash you in his blood.
Så att han kan göra dig fri och vaska dig I sitt blod.
Jesus died for you.
Jesus døde for deg.
The question is, will you live for him?
Men spørsmålet vil du leve for ham?
Our Father in heaven.
Vår himmelske far.
Lord, we thank you so much for your great love and mercy.
Vi takker deg så mye for din store kjærlighet og nåde.
You're the God that performs mighty miracles in our hearts.
At du den Gud som gjør mektige mirakler I våre liv.
That you accept us just as we are.
At du tar imot oss akkurat slik som vi
Broken with issues.
Brutte med mange problemer.
You can change us and give us a new beginning.
Du kan förändra oss och ge oss en ny begynnelse.
Lord, if there's someone here tonight that needs to make that decision.
Och Herre, hvis det någon här ikväll som trenger att göra den beslutningen.
Help them to hear your voice.
Så be om du må hjälpa dem att höra din stämma.
Give them courage to take their stand for eternity tonight.
Och ge dem mod till att ta ett standpunkt för evigheten ikväll.
Send extra angels, Lord.
Send extra änglar, Herre.
To fill this room.
Till att fylla detta rummet.
And give us the power to choose.
Och ge oss kraft till att välja.
And as your heads are bowed and as your eyes are closed.
Och I det hoden böjet och ögonen lockat.
As your heart is open to God in prayer.
Och I det ditt hjärta öppen till Gud I bön.
I'm wondering if tonight there's someone who is being moved by the Spirit of God.
Så lurer jeg på om det någon här ikväll som blir berørt av Herrens ånd.
To a more full commitment to Jesus.
Till ett mer fullt övergivelse till Jesus.
Maybe you're partially committed but not fully committed.
Kanske är du delvis övergivet men inte helt.
Tonight you want to recommit yourself to the Lord.
Och ikväll så önskar du igen att överge dig själv till Herren.
You want to surrender your life once again to Jesus.
Du önskar överge ditt liv till Jesus en gång igen.
Because he died for you.
För det han döde för dig.
You want to say, Lord, help me to live for you.
Så önskar du att se hjälp mig att leva för dig.
If you'd like to recommit yourself to God.
Hvis du önskar att ge ditt liv till Jesus igen.
I'd like to stand to your feet where you are.
Så var så snill och stå upp där.
I'm standing because I'm recommitting myself tonight.
Och jag står för det att jag ger mig själv
till Jesus
igen ikväll.
Please, you make that decision this evening as well.
Må det också ta den beslutningen.
You're recommitting yourself to the Lord.
Gi dere selv over til Jesus.
Stand to your feet as we pray.
Stå sammen I det vi ber.
Before we conclude this prayer.
Och för vi ändrar med bön.
Maybe there's someone here tonight that needs to take the additional step.
Så kan det hända är någon här ikväll som trenger att ta ännu ett steg.
You're not just recommitting in your heart.
Det ger inte bara I livet deras till Jesus.
But you want a new beginning in baptism.
Men det önskar en helt ny erfaring med då.
Or maybe you've fallen away from the Lord.
Eller kanske har du fallit väck från Herren.
You want to come back in rebaptism.
Och du önskar att komma tillbaka och bli gendöpt.
You want the Lord Jesus to wash you thoroughly from your sins.
Du önskar att Herren ska vaska dina synder helt.
To break all the chains of bad habits.
Och bryta all dessa länkarna av dåliga vanor.
And you want the peace today that only heaven can offer.
Och du önskar den freden som bara himlen kan ge.
Is there someone here like that?
Visst är någon som det.
That senses the Lord calling them for a decision for baptism or rebaptism. So would you raise your hand?
Som vet att Herren kallar dig till att bli döpt eller gendöpt.
Heads are bowed, eyes are closed.
Så var så snill, lukk ögonen alla sammen och böj hodene och så räck upp handen av de som har det slik.
If so, I want to have a special prayer for you.
Hvis det sånn, så har jeg lyst til å ha en spesiell bønn for
Because the devil sees your decision.
For djevelen ser deres valg.
He's going to do his best to attack you.
Og han vil gjøre sitt beste for å angripe
dere. So you need special protection tonight.
Så du trenger spesiell beskyttelse I kveld.
Special power and special grace.
Spesiell kraft, spesiell nåde.
And so if that's you, I want to invite you to slip out of your seat.
Og hvis det slik, så ber jeg dem at dere nå står opp fra hvor dere sitter.
And if you'd like to join me up here at this altar.
Og at dere kommer opp her hvor jeg står.
For special
foran,
prayer.
Foran scenen her for spesiell forbønn.
Would you come now?
Hvis dere ønsker det, så kom nå.
God bless you, young man.
Må Gud velsigne deg, unge mann.
God bless you, my dear sister.
Gud velsigne deg, søster.
You're coming because you want a new beginning with Jesus in baptism.
Du kommer fordi du ønsker en ny begynnelse med Jesus I dåpen.
Doesn't mean you're going to get baptized tonight.
Det betyr ikke at du trenger å bli døpt I kveld.
But you want to look forward to that experience in the very near future.
Men du ønsker å se fram imot den erfaringen I nær framtid.
God bless you.
Må Gud velsigne deg.
Heads are bowed, eyes are closed. We're not looking around, we're looking within tonight.
Vi skal ikke se oss rundt omkring, vi skal se på oss selv I kveld.
If you've already made that decision and you've been baptized, you pray for the person next to you that's struggling.
Hvis du allerede har blitt døpt, så be for den personen som ved siden av deg som kjemper.
The one that God is calling this evening to make that decision.
Den som Gud kaller på I kveld til å ta en slik beslutning.
And friend, if that's you, what is holding you back tonight?
Og venner, hvis det deg, hva det som holder deg tilbake I kveld?
What stands between you and Jesus?
Hva det som står mellom deg og Jesus?
Is it some addiction?
Er det avhengighet?
Some cheap pleasure?
Er det noe billig nytelse?
Nothing is worth losing eternity for, friends.
Det ingenting som verdt I forhold til å miste evigheten.
Give it to Jesus tonight.
Gi det til Jesus I kveld.
And receive the assurance of salvation.
Og ta imot denne erfaringen av frelse.
Is there someone else who needs to make this decision?
Er noen flere som trenger å gjøre
baptism or rebaptism in the near future?
Blir døpt eller gjendøpt I nær framtid?
Oh, my brothers and sisters, Jesus is coming again.
Brødre og søstre, Jesus kommer igjen.
There's no time to waste.
Og det ikke noe tid å miste.
God is calling for a full surrender.
Gud kaller på oss for å overgi oss
Jesus gave all for you.
Jesus ga alt for deg.
And he calls you to give all to him tonight.
Og han kaller deg til å gi alt til ham.
Is there someone else who would like to come for a special prayer? God bless you, young ladies.
Gud velsigne dere, unge jenter.
You're making the best decision of your life.
Dere tar den beste beslutningen dere noen
gang kunne ta. Heaven is rejoicing over you tonight.
Himmelen gleder seg over dere I kveld.
But what about you who is still struggling in your seat?
Men hva med dere som fremdeles kjemper der på setene?
God is calling, come now, friend.
Hvis Gud kaller dere, kom nå, venner.
Don't wait until your life is better.
Ikke vent til livet deres bedre.
You can't change your life.
Du kan ikke forandre livet
ditt. The only power you have is the power of choice.
Den eneste kraften du har er valgets
kraft. And God is not calling you to change.
Og Gud kaller ikke deg til å forandre deg.
He's calling you to choose.
Han kaller deg til å velge.
And when you make the decision,
og når du tar den beslutningen,
He will perform the miracle of change in your heart.
Så vil han gjøre det miraklet og endre ditt hjerte.
So you can come tonight just as you are.
Så du kan komme i kveld akkurat som du er.
With any addiction and any struggle and any sin.
Med samme hva slags synd eller avhengighet som du har.
God will take you when no one else will.
Och så vill Gud ta dig emot även om ingen annan vill.
He'll take you as you are.
Han vill ta dig akkurat som du är.
But he won't leave you in that condition.
Men han vill inte låta dig förbli den tillstånd.
He will give you a brand new life.
Han vill ge dig ett helt nytt liv.
The best life you could ever live.
Det bästa livet du kan leva.
And the best version of you is in Christ.
Och den bästa versionen av dig är i Kristus.
So there's somebody else who needs to come and live.
Så visst är någon annan som trenger att komma
leva. A young person that needs to say yes, I want to be God's property.
En ung person som trenger å si, jeg ønsker å tilhøre
Gud. Praise God, God bless you, young ladies.
Please, Gud velsign, må Gud velsigne dere.
Heaven rejoices over you.
Himmelen gleder seg over dere.
God bless you, young men.
Gud velsigne dere.
God is raising up soldiers for His army tonight.
Gud reiser opp soldater for sin hær i kveld.
Chains are being broken this evening.
Og det lenker som blir brutt i kveld.
Young people are coming alive.
Unge mennesker som blir levende.
God bless you, my brother.
Må Gud velsigne deg, bror.
Lord sees your heart.
Gud ser ditt hjerte.
My friends, you don't have to wait for an emotion.
Du trenger ikke å vente på en følelse.
It's far deeper than an emotion.
Det mye dypere enn en følelse.
It's based upon the conviction of the Lord.
Det basert på overbevisningen.
And tonight God is pleading with you.
Og i kveld så kaller Gud på deg.
To choose now before it's too late.
Bønnfaller deg til å velge nå før det for sent.
Before probation closes and Jesus comes.
Før nådedøren lukkes og Jesus kommer igjen.
Get on board the ark of safety, friends.
Kom ombord på arken som trygg, venner.
For there is only security in Christ tonight.
For det bare trygghet i Kristus i kveld.
There's someone else whom the Spirit of God is calling.
Hvis det noen andre som Guds ånd kaller.
Come to the altar and lay down your burdens at Jesus' feet.
Så kom til alteret og legg det byrdene ved Jesu føtter. Gud velsigne deg, unge
mann. Making the best decision of your life.
Du gjør den beste beslutningen i livet ditt.
These individuals are passing from death into life.
Disse her går fra døden til livet.
Is there somebody else who needs to come?
Er det flere som trenger å komme?
Oh, I beg you in Jesus' name, come.
Jeg bare kaller på dere i Jesu navn.
Won't you come and live? God bless you, sister.
Og leve. Gud,
oh, you may be hearing a man's voice.
Det kan hende at du føler at du hører en manns
stemme. But God is speaking tonight.
Men Gud taler i kveld.
And I beg you on behalf of Christ.
Og jeg ber deg på Kristi vegne.
Come and live.
Kom og lev.
Come and be saved.
Kom og bli frelst.
Come and let Jesus wash you of your sins.
Kom og la Jesus vaske dine synder.
God bless you, my brother.
Må Gud velsigne deg.
Praise God, my brother.
Pris Gud.
The Lord sees your heart. It doesn't matter what other people think.
Gud ser hjertene deres, og det gjør ikke noe hva andre tenker.
Don't worry about what others are thinking.
Ikke bry dere om hva andre tenker.
All that matters is what Jesus thinks about you.
Alt som viktig hva Jesus tenker om
deg. And he said that the thoughts I think toward you.
Og han sier at de tankene som jeg tenker om deg.
Are thoughts of peace and not of evil.
Er fredens tanker, ikke ulykkens
tanker. To give you a future and a hope.
For å gi deg framtid og
håp. Come and receive it tonight, friends.
Kom og ta imot i kveld, venner.
Because Jesus is coming soon.
For Jesus kommer snart.
He's calling for 100% committed disciples.
Og han kaller på disipler som 100% overgitt.
And could it be that through your life?
Og det kan være at gjennom deres liv.
And your decision tonight.
Og din beslutning i kveld.
The multitudes in your family.
Så vil mange familien deres.
In your community.
I samfunnet deres.
Will come to know Jesus because of your decision tonight.
De vil komme til å kjenne Jesus på grunn av den beslutningen som du har gjort
Don't
i kveld.
Don't wait until it's too late, friends.
Ikke vent for det, fordi det for sent.
Now is the accepted time.
Nå den riktige tiden.
Is there one more before we pray?
Er det en til før vi ber?
Who senses the Spirit of God calling you?
Som merker at Gud kaller på deg.
You want to come.
Og som ønsker å komme.
Receive the peace of Jesus.
Og ta imot Jesu fred.
Say yes, Lord, I'm moving forward in baptism.
Og som ønsker å si ja, Herre, jeg ønsker å ta dåp.
Going all the way with you, God bless you.
Jeg ønsker å gå hele veien med deg, Gud velsigne deg, søster.
Praise be to God.
Gud velsigne dere.
As we pray.
I det vi ber.
If you sense the Spirit of God calling you,
hvis du føler at Guds ånd kaller på deg,
you need to know, friends, that you can come to the front even during prayer.
Så vit at du kan komme opp her selv når vi ber.
And receive the power of Jesus in your life.
Og få Jesu kraft i ditt liv.
Thank you so much, dear God.
Tack så mycket, kära Jesus.
For the powerful miracle you've performed tonight.
För det fantastiska miraklet som du har gjort ikväll.
Thank you, Lord Jesus, for these precious individuals who have responded to your call.
Tack för dessa dyrbara själar som har tagit emot ditt kall.
They've made the best decision of their lives tonight.
De har tagit den bästa beslutning de någon gång kan göra ikväll.
And I pray, Lord, that their names will be written in the book of life.
Och jag ber om att deras namn må bli skrivet in I livets bok.
And that nothing will blot it out.
Och att ingenting vill slätta det ut.
I pray that you would please cleanse them thoroughly from their sin.
Jag ber om att du må rensa dem helt och fullt från deras synder.
That you fill them with the power of your Holy Spirit.
Och fyll dem med din helige ands kraft.
That wherever there's doubt, that you'll give them faith.
Slik at hvor enn det tvil, så må du gi dem
Where there's
tro.
Weakness, give them strength.
Hvor det svakhet, så må du gi dem styrke.
Where there's fear, give them peace.
Hvor det frykt, så må du gi dem fred.
Where there's sorrow, give them joy.
Hvor det tristhet, så må du gi dem glede.
I pray, Lord, that this decision will be sealed for eternity.
Och jag ber om att denna beslutningen må bli beseglat för
evigt. And as they look forward to their new beginning in the near future.
Och i det de ser fram till en ny framtid och en ny begynnelse.
In the beautiful waters of baptism.
I dopens goda vatten.
That through their lives many more will come to know the joyful sound that Jesus saves.
Så må många bli känt med genom deras liv att Jesus frälser.
So we pray that you'll bless them, Lord.
Så jag ber om att du må välsigne dem.
Send extra angels to surround them.
Send extra änglar till att vara runt dem.
To push back every demonic influence in their lives.
För att ta väck alla satans krafter I deras liv.
Make them thoroughly free in Jesus tonight.
Gör dem helt fri I Kristus ikväll.
And I pray that the world will be blessed through their experience.
Och jag ber om att världen må bli välsignet av deras erfaring.
Lord, for the rest of us, we want to recommit ourselves to you.
Och resten av oss önskar också ge oss själva över till dig.
Take our hearts, Lord.
Ta våra hjärtan, Herre.
Make it your throne.
Och gör det till din trone.
May you be the king of our lives.
Må du vara kung I våra liv.
And now give us peace.
Och nu ge oss din fred.
That our sins are forgiven.
Fred att våra synder tillgivna.
And give us the joy of full salvation tonight.
Och ge oss full frälsningsglädje ikväll.
Thank you for hearing and answering our prayer.
Tack för att du hörer och svarar på våra böner.
We claim it.
För det vi gör krav på det.
We thank you for it in Jesus' mighty name.
Och vi tackar för det I Jesu mäktiga namn.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. I want to invite those who've come to the front, those who've made a decision for the Lord Jesus.
Jag har lyst til at de som skal komme fram, som har bestemt seg for å følge Jesus.
Your name and your information, and so if you'd please just meet us right here on the side of
For vi vil gjerne få navnet deres.
If you folks want to come right here, we have some pastors that will meet
her,
you.
Så det noen pastor som vil møte dere her.
And give you some extra encouragement and extra prayer.
Og gi dere litt en ekstra bønn og litt oppmuntring.
How many of you are thankful for what God has done tonight? Amen.
Hvor mange takknemlige for hva Gud har gjort I kveld?
How many of you want to praise God for these precious friends of ours who've made their
decision? Hvor mange har lyst til å prise Herren for det her?
Praise God.